Welcome everybody. In this video, we will see about the very active dynamic cell organelle, that is mitochondria. Because as you may know, the energy powerhouse of the cell is termed to be mitochondria, which will provide you energy. Now it is providing energy for me to teach you. So each and every cell which are very active, they must possess more number of mitochondria, right? Well, this function of energy production function of mitochondria is well known to everyone. In this video, we will see about what is the size, what is the shape, and what are all the things present in the mitochondria that make them to produce the ATP. And nevertheless, we will discuss about the functions of mitochondria as well. Okay, if you want to more videos like that, you just subscribe our TV channel by clicking the subscribe button present below. Let's see about mitochondria. Now we will see about the history of mitochondria. Who has identified this mitochondria from where? That is a good question, am I right? Mr. Koliker, who has identified these mitochondria from the flight muscles of the insects? The flight muscles are more active, as you may know, in order to fly from one place to another, the flight muscles should function every now and then. So this is a very active part in the insects. This contain more mitochondria. He has identified those things. And later, Mr. Fleming came and he gave the name or term as filia, F-I-L-I-A, filia. And then Mr. Altman, he has given the term bioplast to this organ. He may think that this is giving energy to whole body, so he thinks that this is the bioplast. And later on, Mr. Bender came and he gave the name term mitochondria to this organ. So Bender at last finally given the name mitochondria to this cell organ. Okay. And how many number of mitochondria present in the cell, that vary from one organism to another organism. Why? As I already told, mitochondria is specific for dynamic functions. So those organs which are involved in active motions, they must have more mitochondria when compared to the other. This can be also in the neat examination. So you must be aware. In case of organ, the number is 1. For example, Chlorella and Chlamydomonas, that possess only 1 mitochondria, whereas and then flight muscles of insects, they contain 5 lakh number of mitochondria in a cell. That's very good, you know. In between the 50k, that is 50,000 of mitochondria is present in the amoeba, and 1.5 lakh mitochondria are present in the sea urchin, and then 3 lakh mitochondria is present in the amphibian yak, and as I already told, 5 lakh are present in the flying muscles of the insects. So these numbers vary according to the functions they perform. If the cell is performing more and more functions, then they must have more number of mitochondria in order to provide them energy. That's it. Okay. What is the size? The size of the mitochondria will vary from 0.5 to 2 micrometers. Okay. So the shape also the same remains as such in every cell, but it may vary slightly from one cell to another cell. But the structure remains as same. There will be two different membranes like that. The things will be same, but slight difference may be seen in from one organism to the other organism. Okay, let's we see the structure of mitochondria. Here, this mitochondria has outer membrane. This is the outer membrane, and the next one will be the. This is the inner membrane. This inner membrane has many finger-like projections, as you can see. This is termed to be cristae. C-R-I-S-T-A-E, cristae. Okay. What is the feature of outer membrane? The outer membrane is more permeable. They contain equal proportion of protein as well as lipids. P is to L ratio. That is 1 is to 1. This is permeable. And next one is inner membrane, which contain 2 is to 1 ratio. That is more protein when compared to lipid in case of inner membrane. This is selectively permeable. It is not permeable to all. Whereas outer membrane is permeable to all. And the next thing what you should know, inside the thing, inside the inner membrane, this contain a matrix. What is that? Matrix. This matrix possess various essential constituents like ribosomes and then various enzymes involved in the respiration process like glycolysis and then Krebs cycle, oxidation, so many things in the process of respiration. You can see so many enzymes. These enzymes are present in the matrix. And ribosomes, as you may know, so many ribosomes are also present over here. And in the meantime, this contains the DNA, which is the very important thing. This organelle contains the DNA. This DNA is rich in GC content. GC content is more in mitochondrial DNA when compared to others. And this contains the ribosome, which is 70S type. This is 70S type of ribosome is present. And then DNA and then various enzymes. In the meantime, it contains divalent ions, which is essential for activation of enzymes. What are all the divalent ions? They contain magnesium, Mg2+, manganese, Mn2+, and the iron, Fe2+. These are the divalent ions which are present in the matrix, rich in 3 type of divalent ions, and also rich in enzymes involved in cellular respiration, and they contain DNA, and they contain 70S type of ribosomes. In the meantime, this fluid matrix is yellow pale color due to the presence of riboflavin. What is that? Riboflavin is there, so it is pale yellow in color. The matrix is okay. Let's discuss about this 70S type of ribosome. This contains 70S type. Mostly, you may know the prokaryotes must contain, cytoplasm contain 80S ribosomes, whereas prokaryotes contain 70S ribosomes. Am I right? But this mitochondria, which is present in the eukaryotic cell, that contains 70S ribosome. This gave an evidence to the endosymbiotic theory. That is what? The eukaryotic cell has engulfed the prokaryotic aerobic bacteria or aerobic prokaryotes, which will turned to be organelle over here period of years it turned to be an organelle inside the eukaryotes. So prokaryotes act as a symbiotic association with the eukaryotes. This theory, endosymbiotic theory or symbiotic theory of mitochondria, was given by Altman. He wrote this endosymbiotic theory. According to him, the aerobic prokaryote was engulfed by the eukaryote. Then it turned to be a function as a organelle in the eukaryotic cell. Therefore, the prokaryote which contained ribosome 70S type, similarly the mitochondria also possess the 70S type of ribosomes. This is the very very important thing you need to know. Okay. Next thing, it is termed to be semi-autonomous. What is mean by semi-autonomous? Autonomous means, you know about colleges, you came to know some of the colleges can be autonomous college. They can able to conduct its own examinations. They can able to give their own question papers. They can able to validate their answer sheets, and they can publish their result as per the wish. They can able to function on their own. That is autonomous. Semi-autonomous means off. The power is, they have the power to function to certain extent, that is semi-autonomous organelle. Because these one contain its own DNA and also this contain its own ribosomes, which is 70S type. So they can able to synthesize their own proteins according to their wish, or enzymes according to their wish. As you may know, the central dogma, DNA to mRNA, mRNA to protein. So they have their own DNA. They are able to synthesize the protein with the help of ribosomes. So they can be able to function on its own. Therefore, this is termed to be semi-autonomous. This can be out from the apes. You just aware. Mitochondria is termed to be semi-autonomous organelle because it contains own DNA as well as the own ribosomes, which is 70S type. And then next question. The mammalian species, mothers like us, we have the ribosomes which is different from the eukaryotes. That is, ribosome will be 55S type in case of mammalian mitochondria. That there will be two subunits. One is the larger and another one is the smaller subunit. The larger subunit will be 38S type, whereas the smaller subunit will be 28S type. 38 larger subunit and smaller subunit will be 28. So these are the function, these are the structure about the mitochondria. Can I now I will give you a short description and main description. Here this is the outer membrane which contains the protein lipid ratio as 1:1. This is the inner membrane. This inner membrane possesses the protein level 2:1. In between the two, this is termed to be perimitochondrial space, which contains the enzyme succinyl dehydrogenase essential for respiration. This will come later. You just know some enzyme succinyl dehydrogenase is present in the perimitochondrial space or outer compartment. Within the inner compartment, you can see the finger-like projections that is termed to be cristae, and there is a matrix. This matrix is pale yellow color due to the presence of riboflavin, and this contains many things, DNA which is rich in GC content and ribosomes which is 70S type, similar to prokaryotes, so that supports the endosymbiotic theory. And in the meantime, this is rich in cellular enzymes essential for respiration, and this is rich in more divalent ions which can activate the enzymes magnesium, manganese and the iron. Then the ribosomes can be 55S type, that is present in mammalian species. The largest subunit will be 38 and smaller will be the 28S type. These finger-like projections may contain the things that is termed to be oxysomes. These oxysomes play a very important role in the synthesis of ATP. So these finger-like projections contain many such exosomes or F0, F1 particle or elementary particle. We will see about the oxysomes in the coming up slide of mitochondria. Thank you. One and all, thank you.